This tutorial shows you how to conduct the Mann-Whitney-Wilcoxon test in R and interpret its results. Its purpose is testing two groups for differences, or put more technical, if they originate from the same distribution or not. It is the non-parametric alternative to the two sample t-test. For example, I want to test for the gender pay gap, meaning I have a fictitious sample of men and women and their respective income. The requirements for the Mann-Whitney-Wilcoxon test are the following: two independent groups and a dependent variable on at least the ordinal scale. As a first step after importing data, I want to see some parameters like the median or quartiles 1 and 3. Mean and standard deviation are fine too for a first impression. You can use the describe by function from the psych package for mean, median and SD. I can see that the median for women is 2400 and for men 2875. The quartiles can be calculated with some piping based on the summarize function of the dplyr package. The quartiles 1 and 3 are also higher for men than women, giving us a hint of a possible gender pay gap. You can also visualize the income of the groups by using box plots and seeing the interquartile range represented by the height of the box and the median by the black horizontal line. Now I want to test whether the medians are significantly different from each other. For this I use the wilcox_test function of the rstatix package. Simply put the name of your data frame first and afterwards the dependent variable followed by tilde, that small wave symbol, and put the group variable behind it. Please note that the default testing will be two-sided, meaning you test for only a difference. In case you proposed in advance that your first group has a greater median than the second one, you can add the argument alternative equals greater. This works if you simply have numbers for groups. If you have names for groups, the alphabetical order is used. If you hypothesized a smaller median for group 1, use alternative equals less. I can now run this one line and get the results. If the p-value is below my predefined threshold, for example 0.05, the null hypothesis can be rejected. Reminder, the null hypothesis assumes no difference of the medians between the two tested groups. In my case, I defined alpha as 0.05 and can therefore reject the null hypothesis because my p-value is lower with 0.0282. Hence, I can conclude that the median income for men and women in my fictitious sample is different. After a significant Mann-Whitney-Wilcoxon test, an effect size should be calculated, which is shown in the following video.